Welcome to your source for research innovation news, insights, and commentary. Research Business Daily Report, sponsored today and all this week by Socratic Technologies, whose proprietary tools and methodologies tackle marketing complexities so that you can make more confident business decisions. Jim Belosik, writing on SmartBlog on social media, has declared that companies should never take a vacation from Facebook. He said he was frustrated after seeing his company's posts reach only 2% of their intended audience and often garner lackluster engagement. So he began to question the fact that he was posting 3 to 4 times a day. And he experimented by posting not at all for a week, then posting once or twice a day for the next week, and then upping his posting to 3 to 5 times a day the week after that. He found that by reducing to one or no posts, he was dropping the company's Talking About Us number from about 3,000 to 600. No big surprise. And Belosik admitted, quote, "We're still working on rebuilding that number up," end of quote. He said, "You have to test, and test again, a week at a time, what your diverse audience is interested in hearing to get the results you're looking for." Next, Google settled a class action lawsuit with two searchers who had accused it of sharing their search queries with third parties without the user's knowledge. Google has agreed to pay $8.5 million. It's going into a settlement fund, which is going to be distributed to 7 groups specifically for use of public education and research related to online privacy. Those groups include Carnegie Mellon, Chicago Kent College of Law, Harvard University's Berkman Center, the Stanford Center for Internet and Society, not too shabby. As part of the settlement, Google is going to post disclosures on its website concerning user search queries. A spokesman said Google is particularly pleased to bring clarity to users around how referrers work. Next, a Mintel social media analyst team has released its first of planned quarterly social media trend updates. Mintel's analysts Gabby Lieberman and Liz Martinez delivered the top 5 current trends, the first being the power of family, friends, and online community. Second, the influence of online chatter for selection of mobile phone services. Third, fictional characters. Think the Geico Gecko and Flow for Progressive Insurance, helping to unease financial markets. 4, online behaviors having ever more impact on consumer behavior and buying. And 5, even more innovative campaigns on the part of brands to capture consumer attention. Cited examples include Frito-Lay's Do Us a Flavor and Domino's rebranding campaigns. And one final note, Rick Lenny, the former chairman of Hershey Company, at one time the president of Nabisco and Pillsbury, and a longtime Kraft senior level player, has been named the new chairman of Information Resources, Inc. It's quite an impressive hire on several levels. That's your Research Business Daily Report, sponsored by Socratic Technologies, whose proprietary tools and methodologies tackle marketing complexities so that you can make more confident business decisions. Underneath our video is a link to Socratic's homepage. You should check it out to find out about its unique capabilities and quality. I've seen them in action for almost 20 years, and they're quite impressive. Have a great research day, and we'll see you all on Thursday.